Welcome to this video tutorial. It has been quite some time. However, this is your brother AK, as you can see here. This time I've made it large. But we'll get back to when it is small. SolidWorks, we are going to continue with the design of electric tri bike. This time we are going to look at a solid spike for the wheel. We're going to design that, so we shall do the advertisement and so on later in the towards the end of this video. So without further ado, let's jump in. Launch your SolidWorks like this. If you have saved it in the taskbar, mine here, I can just click and it opens itself once. Yours might delay, wait for it to start. In that case, I'm going to switch off this big screen which shows me. However, it's not getting dark, so that's why you see a lot of these blinging things around. Nevertheless, I'm going to close that and then I switch on this tiny one. There I am. This is your brother AK, so I'm going to put at the corner there. So let's open. If you have never watched any of my previous tutorials, I recommend you first watch the first earlier tutorials. Just head to YouTube channel, and when you click on that and you are viewing me on YouTube channel, look for my profile picture, click on the profile picture, and it will take you directly to my channel. That way you can get a list of the lessons in an organized manner. You too can also subscribe at a small cost, 25,000 per module, that's in Ugandan shillings, or an equivalent in US dollars. And you can make that payment through the website by visiting Edu training page, which I will show you at the end of this lesson. But for now, let's get started with today's lake coverage. So when I open here, click on this to open, and it will be able to open. Yeah, so the bit it opens, I have some of these sketches here. This is a sketch of my electric tri bike, which actually we're working on. But I want to use that for a particular part of it for this lesson, especially working on the rear tire. So this rear tire, I'm going to finish up that rear tire in this tutorial. Then we shall continue the other body parts and so on, the other structures, the chassis and so on, for the other module, which is basically for the learning lesson. But the actual work is starting tomorrow, 6th of October 2020. However, that one we are going to keep it a little secret because the design is unique. But what we're going to design here is what is existing, but our unique one which we're working on, we shall not make it public. Alright, so let's get started. Click on open. When you click open, give it a small time, it will be able to launch on this interface here. Yeah, just a little while, it's going to open. Okay. So, not responding. I don't know why. SolidWorks is not responding. So I think okay, it has cleared. All right, it's now opening. So. Just a little while, it should be able to open. I do not know why it is taking that long. However, there could be a lot of background activities running. So this finally opens. Oh, okay. So here it is. I think it's not the entities are not fully loaded. So there may be a lot of background activities. You never know. Okay. So this is previously how one can come up with. So if you want to see how this was built up, let me show you from the sketch. If I move this up, this handle, just move and get this handle like that and drag it up to the first module, the rest of the features will be hidden from view. If you wait for a while, it will hide all, and this is basically what will revolve. And what did you revolve? Look at the cross-sectional sketch. This is the sketch that we developed in. So we produce this one here, and then you produce this, and then use this revolve tool to generate this. So if I click on edit, it will be able to see the actual sketch from which we produced this drawing. So you can find out how this came out, and you click on this and click normal, or you can hit Control 8 to see that. So it is crowded with entities. If you don't want to view these entities, you just come to this camera and take away these sketch entities. This is sketch entity, so it will remove the sketch entities. It will be left with the dimensions. If you also we take away these are dimensions. If we take the dimensions away, let me see, let's go. Somehow it has remained, no problem. Let me put it back on. So when I zoom, I can now see. So this is the profile which revolves. This is the pattern which you can design something like this, similar using the sketch entities. This is the combination of from here to here is a spline. This tool here, just click and click and click and click and click. If you don't know how to click and so on, follow the first tutorials and the second and the third and the introduction to SolidWorks, and this will be done. Or you can give me an email at anguzokennedy@yahoo.com or anguzokennedybada@gmail.com. Alright, without further ado, what I'm saying, the website, if you don't get this, let me show you where you can go. When I open that on Notepad, I should show you that it is Anguzu Kennedy Swift at Yahoo. You can use Anguzu Kennedy Bada Swift at gmail.com. So any of the two, or you can visit even my the website akvirtualrealities.com, and then choose one, hit enter and choose home from Google search list, and there you go. So there, with this you can get in touch and ask any part of the learning session, and I can produce for you. So let me see also here, this is the pattern. You can see we had to use this tool. This tool is the sketch fillet and sketch chamfer. Chamfer is when it is straight, and the fillet is when it is curved. So the edges have been smoothened, and this also is filleted to produce that. And then this basically, one is smaller, one is bigger, one is for break, one is for chain. The chain will be passing over one of these. So this bigger one is for chain, and this small one is for the break. So break will be basically applied to this, and this one will also will apply the chain. All right. As you can see, most motorcycles employ only the brake on one side, but the brake shoe pad. So normally it is advisable to implement on this side and even on the lower side, so that you have overall a bigger application. Just like for the vehicle it's not only one side. You find there is the upper one and there is the lower one, or there is another one, there's another one, only two which anchors it for the drum type, and the same as for the one which uses the caliper, the disc brake. So we have the disc brake and the drum brake. So this is basically going to be a disc brake here. All right, so without further ado, now this is when I say escape, this profile had given us this revolution. Now this one was added. This pattern here is just from the SolidWorks material. If you see that material, you find that there is the rubber material. You don't need to create this pattern as design, otherwise you will have so many entities to deal with and it can overload the system. So just use the appearances, a two-dimensional image that is mapped onto this. So where is that one? Ah, rubber. When you click on rubber to expand, you see texture, and this is the tire tread which were put here. There's also perforated rubber and the textured rubber. So we use tire tread. This is a tire tread. Cancel done. I'm not applying any color to it yet. We shall apply the color later. Now, so I want to get back the other features by rolling this one forward like that. You drag it down and they will all appear. So you can see this cut all parts purposely cut to ensure that the purpose of these holes is to lessen the overall weight reduction. So we are reducing weight in actual sense. Alright, so let me see. Let me see the design. So in this case, we're going to draw a solid spike here, which is a curved one, 6 of them. So how do we do? To do that, first get the plane on which you're going to draw. So we front plane is far away, as you can see. Top plane is within the drawing, and the right plane is also within. You can choose right plane. Click on it and click that one, or you can come to sketch and click on sketch. It will begin the sketching process and go to view and choose normal. When you see normal view, you won't see the center of it because of this color. In that case, go here and choose wireframe. When you choose wireframe, you'll be able to expose the inside. Alright, now we have to use a center line. So how would you get a center line? Go here, choose center line, and get the middle of this. You will see this small box which is yellow in the middle, and when you point over to it and you see it's going like that, moving up. So if you move off, it goes away, but as long as you come here, it will begin to trace down. Then you move, click there and move it over, and you can move it, stop anywhere. Okay, no problem, you can stop it even there. Press escape on the keyboard. Then we are going to draw, this time around it's not center line, but it's just line, not midline, but line. So we want to start on this one here, on top of that. So I'm going to click somewhere there, and I'm going to move it over at an angle, just an arbitrary angle, because we're not going to fabricate that physically. That one is already done, is already manufactured, so we're simply going to use it as it is already manufactured. Okay, that now what you're going to do is also produce another line starting from use an arc. I want to click an arc here to produce a fillet radii. Don't mind about this because of this rectangular thing, otherwise it is within it. Then also click there and point there, and then do something of that kind, something like that. And then you use trim entities. This makes sure that trim to closest is selected, and trim off that. So once you've done, then go down, zoom it down, and you see that the fillet is very, very small, but it's okay. Now this time around, we can use a fillet here. So we're going to reproduce a fillet. We're going to produce a fillet also for this. I'm going to move this over, and I click to stop somewhere there, and press escape. You see, so there now I'm going to produce a fillet on that corner. So expand here, choose fillet, and that fillet is 10. So if you click that and it goes to 10, and 10 certainly is too big, even if it's a weld bead, too big. So probably 6 will be okay. Now I click tick, and it's going to produce like that, as you can see. Now in that case, I'm just going to use this one to produce this one onto. Okay, before I do that, let's just mirror it over. Even this one, we might not need it at this time. Let me select it and press delete key to move it away. Now I'm going to go over to mirror entities. Now it asks me to mirror the entities. The entities I want to mirror is this line over the other side. So the entities are mirror, making sure that this field is selected, not this one. Are we seeing how the blue is switching? If you select this one, you must select the mirror about, means the mirror line. You must select this one. Then the entities are this. This line is an entity. The fillet is also an entity. The lower fillet is also an entity. And this other small piece of the portion of the line is also an entity. Click tick and then go over to that 3-point arc, select that and select this other point arc, and then click here. So once you've done that, then you come over and you click here and you click over there, then you click there. So click tick and then I want to draw another line here so that you can use this one to revolve over. Alternatively, we can use center axis, this center axis here. Alright, so exit the sketch first, because this sketch is already finished and is a closed loop. And then change it back to trimetric here. Right click and then like this. Then go to view, choose that, and then you are going to make this one to revolve. So go to features and then choose revolved boss. Now choose this sketch and then you revolve it all around. So before we do that, select again, somehow it doesn't, select again and then right click, clear the remove that selection, and then select this one, and then it identifies that. But let's just be certain, go to selected contours and inside here make sure this contour is selected and this contour is also selected. Let us see if it is selected, the bottom one. Yeah, this one you may not necessarily select it, you can leave this one like that so that, because it is unnecessary. So you can use like that. This also is okay, because the other one is unnecessary. Now this is okay, and then you can click tick to finish and it will revolve it all over. Okay, like that. As you can see, this plate radii shows a very small portion here. So now we can go here, remove this, rotate by right clicking. So open again this and remove this temporal axis. What you call temporal axis is this one. This is called temporal axis. Now if you select this face and try to right click, although there's a deep sketch, but then there is no sketch, and you can, because this face is landing, and in that case we are going to use another alternative. The alternative we're going to use is to use this face. Now you can see there is a sketch, not a deep sketch. You have to use a sketch. Alternatively, you can use this sketch here. There is this one. When you click on that, it will look as if we are sketching on this face, because this face is the planar and flat. And therefore, come up here and choose normal to view it normal. Now here we have to be very, very careful on the edge we are cutting through. Now to do that, we are going to use shader with hidden lines visible. Now with hidden lines visible, okay, there's a little bit of confusion. I want to get it back to that. When I get it back to that, it will show me, so this is the one. Then there is also, let me see, there is also that edge. So in that case, I can use, set it with that. Now, and I'm going to use this tool, which is, and then I use this lower one, 3-point arc. What I'm using is called 3-point arc. Then I look inside the hole. Now, this can appear to be confusing. If it appears to be confusing, take it back, view it back with that, so that you can see where it is going through. And when you click that, it tries to click and stop. Let me press escape and I try to start afresh here by drawing that, not starting the whole thing, but just so that's the point I want to use. And you look for the lower one, that is like a diamond shaped. Then you go and look for another one on diamond shaped, which is on this other one. That is the one, diamond shaped. Now, the angle I prefer to use is angle of 180. So I put 180 as the arc radius for that. Then I use another one, 3-point arc, and this time I want to make it go over this other one behind it, but I want to make sure it is close by there. And then I use I don't want to use that, but I want to use halfway, maybe around there, not even exactly halfway, just somewhere there is okay. And then I move it over. This will be a bit bigger, but I'm going to correct. It is looking a little bigger there. So in that case, this I'm going to change it to from 180 to 170. So 170 is okay. Then move this one closer to the other one there. Once you move like, so that this close to the tire from the axle, this is the center point from the wheel hub here. This is the wheel hub. From the wheel hub towards the rim is narrowing, as you can see. Users too also must be narrowing like that. Make sure it narrows. Okay, all right. We won't use filleted idea there, and then there. Like that, it doesn't look so convincing, but no problem. That one can be that. So then also fillet radii from here to that. Make sure it is highlighted yellow first before you do anything to it. Like that. Then go to trim entities and take away this portion and take away the other portion. And this we can sort of use fillet radii to add in a more curve. We can put it there and we increase the fillet radii and for some reason it doesn't increase. Oh, okay. I think it is saying it is too small. So cancel, just don't do anything more there. Cancel it off. Now these are our sketch entities. Now we want to radially populate this sketch entities radially by using linear sketch pattern. You expand here, you choose circular sketch pattern. Where there is linear sketch pattern, you find the circular sketch pattern. After clicking, it will open like this, and here it tells you which entities, number of entities we want, six of these entities. And then we want it to be about the radial point. So even if you don't select the radial point, it will identify, because this avatar is located at the center point, thankfully enough. As you can see, that one has gone to 6, this one has also gone to 6. Let us see, is it merging on 2? There's the crisscrossing, no problem. That one will be very good actually for us. Then we also do with this and that. So this tutorial is coming to 30 minutes, but we don't want to be beyond 30 minutes. We don't want it for an hour, no. So having done that, you can click on tick. Now we zoom here in the middle and try to take away the overlapping features, delete away the overlapping, and that and that and that and that. So delete away what is overlapping like that. Delete even away overlapping feature, delete away overlapping features, overlapping features like that. So once you have deleted the overlapping features, you're also going to fillet radii it, to choose the fillet radii this time, maybe something like 5. Let us see, 5 I think is very very ideal. Fillet radii 5 is conveniently ideal. I have liked it when it is that. So this is okay, and then click tick to finish that fillet radii. Nothing on the outside, therefore close that on X. Okay, now this is a nice pattern we want for this rear circle. Okay, so since we're going to cut through, we can also generate pattern along this edge for removing material. This time I want to use helical. I put there and I go and click that, sorry, this helix does not look okay. It is not giving me what I want. In that case, let me still use this one here, and it's going to be 3-point arc. I'm going to have to zoom big here and somewhere here. I bent it slightly and then outwards, just narrow like that. Another one will be triangular. No, another one will be this. Another one will be that, going towards the center and move it like that. And click there again towards the edge and move it over like that. And then here, click there and drag it over like that. Then the other end, we're going to use fillet radii. Right click, clear selection. That's not what we want. Now you're going to fillet to something like 2, just a narrow fillet radii like that. And click tick. Alright, so in this case, as you can see, we're going to again also do populate this across all over it. How do we do that? First, exit this sketch fillet. Now, we're going to do what we call circular pattern, circular sketch pattern, and then 2 minutes left. Okay, we're about to finish. Don't worry. Click that, increase the number to 6, and it'll be able to fit exactly. Select this, select that, and zoom big from the wheel mouse here. You roll it, you roll it forward, you roll it back, you roll it forward, roll it back, roll it forward, roll it back. That is the wheel mouse for zooming and zooming out and in. Now, so having done that, you can see it populating 6, and then click finish by clicking tick there. Click anywhere else. Then we join this so that we can get closed sketch entities. Close up the sketch entities and click there and point to that. Click align with that. Do the same. Don't populate this one because we're looking at those points which are closing them. If you're going to populate it, you might run into problems. unless you want to experiment. Otherwise, like that, and that, and there. We too are also going to pull this here. And we're going to move it over to that, and we're going to click there, and we're going to move to that, and we're going to move it over to that, and click it there, and then close up with this other one. Finish it up with. That minus will have been utilized. We're encroaching in another extra minutes. Don't worry. Will be done shortly. Okay, so click tick, and so sketch is complete, and exit the sketch, and then if you, this sketch is now complete, but if we right click and roll it over, we find the sketch is offset. Have we seen sketch is outside? If you look at that, the sketch is outside, it's aligned with that face, but that is no problem. Now this now calls for a real trick. Now select this, make sure it's highlighted, and go to features and use extrude card. So when you're going to use extrude card, okay, let's just see direction, it's cutting that way, which is okay. Right click and choose rotate, and then choose so that you can see. Now if we start from that point, it's going to take away some of this material which we do not want. Therefore we want to start off certain distance away. To do that, you view it on the edges, you can view on the sides like that. Now when you view on the sides, this cutting must start offset, so not from the sketch plane, but offset by, let's say 10. It starts from behind when you click this one to reverse it, reverse direction like that. So you can see now, if you zoom, it is not starting from this sketch plane, from the sketch itself, but starting 10 millimeters away from the sketch plane, which is in and out. In that case, it will not cut any of the materials here. So do that and make it go up to this other side. Then by increasing now the blind, go to blindly, blindly 100 there, exactly there you will find it will cut it through a very nice pattern, and then you can click tick to finish the cutting. Once it finishes the cutting, it should be able to be seen. So right click and rotate, and you get a very nice pattern without cutting the outer one. And this is a very cool looking wheel ring which will merge with the other one. So allow me stop at this level. You can go ahead and do the painting. I will do the painting, but I'm not going to show you now. So do the painting. If you find the problem with it, please let me know. So this guys, for them, they have done it in some slight way. Those who have already manufactured a similar one like this types of rail. Okay, so that's it for now. Save your work, control save. It will save your work. Now the star is no longer there. And then you can close here and quit SolidWorks. I'm not going to quit for you. Can close here on exit to go, but I don't want to quit because I'm going to use it in the next part. Just going to minimize it down, and I say that's it for now. But I want to show you a little bit of marketing. If you head over, I want to show you on paint. Okay, maybe next time. Never worry. If on paint here, if you just need more lessons on whichever card lesson, whether it is Revit, whether it is SolidWorks, whether it is AutoCAD, whether it is Maya, whether you want to produce cartoons and so on, please let me know, and I can give you dedicated tutorials at just a simple small cost in a few US dollars, or in equivalent Ugandan shillings, about 25 to 30 per each module. We have a number of modules, the module I mean, the subject learning you are taking. For example, if you're learning SolidWorks, you're going to be paying 25 Ugandan shillings or an equivalent for a month. And if you're taking in a number of other courses related, and remembering that in computing we use what we call integrated design. Your designs are integrated, so in that case you will need paint is not responding for some reason. Okay, just don't want to prolong this for so long, but Oh, so it has come to, I want to change that one to done. So when I go click again, it will be on 22. So what I was doing, what I wanted you to show you is that, so AK virtual realities.com / edu lessons, edu training is where you can subscribe and get lessons there, and you can from the same website you can also contact me and arrange your payment, and you can have a platform where video lessons can be sent plus some other PDF tutorials directly into your link. You can also email at anguzu kennedy shift at yahoo.com, or you can use anguzu kennedy at yahoo.com. alternatively, you can use the telephone contact +256 773 655 3556. You call it on MTN line Uganda. You can also use 2.256 750 90 28 20 Airtel line Uganda. So any of that, you can get in touch with me. That's it for now, guys. See you in the next tutorial.